Hey folks, it's Eugene here with another quick tip video. It's just a short one today. And this one has to do with a question that came up a little while ago having to do with exporting meshes and creating PDFs. So, you know, it's something you might be able to send someone and share. So you can do that inside of 3DF Zephyr. And you can do it once you create a model of something based on your photographs, but you can also bring in an OBJ model or a 3D model that's already meshed and export it. So it doesn't have to be created in photogrammetry either. So let me give you a quick rundown here. And like I said, this is going to be fairly succinct. So this is just a quick model that I did on the screen of, you know, part of a sidewalk, took some photographs and then processed it. So I've got a 3D model. Now, whenever you want to export to a PDF, you want to try and optimize the model. So let me just give you an idea here what's going on. I got a couple of meshes here. Let me bring one up. So this is one of them. And if we go in and look at the wireframe, okay, you'll see that I've got a lot of little patches here. Okay, so it's got a very high polygon count. Now, if it's just to send to somebody and, you know, they want to see what it looks like or whatever, I may not want to have this many polygons. It'll just be a lot easier for them to run on their computer. So you can optimize the mesh. Okay, so this is an optimized mesh. So maybe a little bit too optimized, okay, because there's a lot of patches and stuff like that. But if you were to just shut that off and look at the mesh, actually here, I've actually textured this already. Let me bring that up. That's what it looks like, okay? So it still looks just as good. But if I turn on the wireframe, you see that it's got all of this stuff over it. So it's not too bad. This is a much lighter patch count and something that you can send out to somebody. And the way you would do that, let me show you that. I'll go back here very quickly. This was the original mesh that I had. Let me go back here just like that. And you want to go up into tools. You want to go to mesh filters and decimation. So when you click on decimation, bring it up here. It basically gives you a target patch count. So, or a target number of vertices. So here I got like 262,000 of 520 something. So I could turn this way down. I can turn this down to like, you know, only 50,000 or something like that. And then what I want to do is go clone and apply filter. Okay. So I'll do that. Let's see what happens. It's going to take a little while. And, through the magic of video editing, I won't let you watch this part. So I'll just have it come back, once it's all done. Okay, well, that's not too bad. Now you can see the color doesn't look all that great. That's because I'm just dealing with the mesh and not the texture. But let's have a look at how I've reduced the polygons. Okay, much less, right? I got a lot less triangles and stuff. Still kind of high in some areas, but whatever. It's less. If I wanted to have less polygons, I just change that number, that 50,000, turn it down to 15,000 or 10,000. Now, if you turn it down too much, it's going to oversimplify the model. So a lot of fine details and things will start to disappear. But for the purposes of what we're doing here, that's just fine. So next step here would be that I need to retexture this. So I have to go back up into my workflow and here it says textured mesh generation. So I'm going to click on that. And that is, I'm just going to use the defaults, general default single texture. And when I go run, it's going to take this, you know, this optimized mesh that I just created or that's decimated, and it's going to retexture it. So basically, while I have these larger patches and stuff like that, it's going to go back to the original images and it's going to find all the pixels that fit in that patch. And so ultimately, when I get the final model, it's going to look really good. It's going to look like basically identical to what I had with the higher resolution mesh. So I'll give it a second here and then we'll look at it when it comes back. Okay, so it just finished. Let me go have a look. I'm going to get rid of that. Let me shut off the cameras. All right. So there you go. I mean, it looks pretty good, just like the original, very close to it. And it's just those textures. It kind of tricks my eye into thinking that there's a lot more resolution there than there really is. So no big deal. Now from here, what I want to do is, let's say I want to export this as a PDF. Well, all you have to do is go up to the export and we're going to export the textured mesh. Okay. That's what we're working on right now. The one with all the colors and stuff. So I'm going to click on that. And from here, it tells me which item is being exported. So I want number 3. That's the one that I just did. And here it says the format. So on the format, you might be tricked here to thinking that it's only 3D type of exports. But if you go down, you've got this PDF 3D. that's what I want. I want to export a 3D PDF, which is great. A couple of other little options here. I'm not going to deal with these right now. Let's just go straight into exporting the 3D PDF. It wants to save it someplace. So I'm just going to do this on my desktop. So I'll save it as textured mesh number 3, whatever. And I'm going to go ahead and save. Okay, so it's just going to go ahead and it's going to write that particular file. And then once it's done, I'll have a PDF. I'll launch it. I'll open it. But there are a couple things that I'll just show you in there. I won't get too crazy with that, but just a couple little tips on opening and kinds of things you might be able to do with the PDF. So as soon as it's done, we'll come right back. Okay, so it looks like it's done. So let me go ahead and fish out that PDF. Okay, so I just opened the PDF, and the first time you open it, you might have a little problem. It gives you like a little warning, you know, multimedia and stuff like that. So if you go to the options, it says trust this document one time or always. I'm just going to go always. And I found that I just have to click in the main view here, click, and you see that basically I've got this model here. Now the controls for this are pretty simple. So left mouse button is to rotate. The scroll wheel is to zoom in and out. Now if you want to pan though, you have to click the left and the right mouse button at the same time. So I'm going to just do that, and you see I can pretty much get anywhere that I need to by just clicking on, you know, these three buttons here, okay? Or these three controls. Now, once I'm in here, there are some other things you can do. And again, without getting too crazy, right-click menu is your friend. So just go ahead and click right-click, and you've got tools, right? You've got views and things like that. And there's some other things here. So let's just look at the tools. Probably the one that might be interesting to some people is this 3D measurement tool. So if I click on that, it gives you some instructions sometimes. I've shut off the default message that comes up, but I'm just going to click. And I'm going to click, and then I'm going to go like that. And you see, I got a measurement, click, click, and then you see I've got another measurement. Okay. So, pretty simple to do. And there's menus, and there's somebody out there that probably knows a lot more about this than me because I've just played with these a little bit. There's different ways to take measurements and snapping and things like that. So, but that's pretty cool. That, you know, the fact that you can do this and set this up for, you know, somebody sends you some, model and you can take some measurements from it. The other thing you can do is, let me escape from this. You can also change the, view mode. So for example, views, you've got, default views. So this will always snap back to the original position. But let's say you want to look at this as a wireframe. So it's got viewing options, and then it's got the, let's see here, the render modes. So now it's a solid, but let's say I want the wireframe. I want to see what my wireframe was. I'll click on that, and you can see I get to see all the patches and all the lines and things like that. And you can change them. There's other options there. You know, you can go to illustration, something like that. So just fun things that you can do. But there's a number of things there. And the most important thing to remember is if you do the right clicking, okay, that'll bring up menus where you can do different things, change lighting and all that sort of stuff. Okay. So that's how you can get to a PDF. Now, I mentioned that you don't have to run a 3D model inside of, or create the model from photographs inside of 3DF Zephyr. If you have an existing model, it could have come from another scanner or something like that. So long as it's a meshed object, you'll be okay. You should be able to bring it into 3DF Zephyr and it can export it as a PDF. So you know what? Let's go ahead and do that and we'll see what happens. Okay, so I have a clear version here of 3DF Zephyr, nothing in the window. And what I'm going to show you is you can import a model. So I'm just going to go ahead and go import, and I'm just going to import a model. And I have this cobalt here. Just, it's an OBJ file. So I'm going to click on it. It does have textures and stuff like that. So you can see it just opened. Great. And again, doesn't have to come from 3DF Zephyr. It can come from other sources. So long as it's a meshed object, you should be pretty much good to go. So from here, I'm happy with this. You could spend time scaling or doing different things, but we're just going to go ahead and go to the export. We're going to export the textured mesh. And now it says it's an OBJ. It's using the Cobalt 4. We have to go to the PDF, right? So let's drop down here. Go to the PDF 3D. Great. And I'm not going to hit any of these options. I'm just going to go ahead and export, and I'm just going to call it Cobalt 4. I'm going to save it and let it do its thing. Once it's done, I'm going to open it up as a PDF and we'll see what happens. Okay, so it's opened up. The PDF is there. The cobalt is here. And just like before, you can change different settings and different things that as you need. Now, I didn't get the warning that came up here, probably because I had opened a similar file before. So if you get the warning, just make sure to hit the drop down where the options are and just trust the document. And once you trust the document, click on the main screen and this opens up. And again, right click is your best friend. So just open it up. You have all your different options here for measurements, for viewing, for render modes, for lighting, and you can play with it from there. So that's it for this one. Just a quick tip on exporting PDFs. If you want to share it with people, it's very important to share your models so they can appreciate them in the form that they exist. And yeah, hope you enjoyed that one. We'll see you soon, folks. Bye-bye.